Hi, I'm Wes with Noria. We're on a mission to make the world better through lubrication excellence. Pretty much every oil out there has additives in it, and a very common one for gear oils is EP, or what are known as extreme pressure additives. Now, these are great additives for supporting higher loads, and basically they result in a mild chemical polishing of the gear teeth, but they work well. They don't destroy gearboxes as fast. It holds up to the loads better. But we do have to be careful when we are using EP additives when we have a yellow metal or a copper alloy like brass or bronze, and we typically find these in worm gears. So if we're using a worm gear box, we want to try to avoid those EP additives. One way to know if it has EP additives in it is, of course, to look at the name. Several gear oils out there say, you know, EP220 or EP320, which means that it's an EP gear oil, that it's got a viscosity of 220 or 320. Another good way to look at it is to look at the technical data sheet. This one test in particular, the ASTM D130, the copper strip corrosion test, is a good one to look at to see how active this oil actually stains or tarnishes copper. If we start to see higher levels of it, like a 1B or a 2A, that's telling you that there's some reaction going on with the copper. So we need to avoid it, especially in higher temperatures, you know, above 60 degrees Celsius. Those additives can be very, very detrimental and lead to the destruction of the copper metals, the highly corrosive environment. So while all additives in oil serve a purpose, we do have to make sure that you match the oil and the additives with the application. We do a lot of this with our Noria Lubrication Program Development, or LPD services. For more information on the LPD services, or to have us come out there and help you select the right lubricants, please visit us at noria.com.